Hi and welcome to this quick tutorial on virtual environment scanning. Lansweeper scans both vCenter and Citrix virtual environments. To take a look at this, we start on the dashboard here. So as you can see here on the left-hand side, we have our vCenter overview, and on the right-hand side, we have our Citrix pool overview. On the left-hand side, we have our different vCenter servers with their data centers below it, the Esxi servers below them, and then the guests that are on that Esxi server. All of these are hyperlinked, so I could simply click on any of these to get more information about them. We'll start with the vCenter ones. So we'll head over to one of our vCenter servers. Here in our vCenter, we have an overview of the most important information that we retrieve from it. So we get information like the version, build, the licensed product version, some API version as well, the operating system, and below that, some network information. Then at the very bottom, if we scroll down, we see the data center that it's running, and also the ESXi servers that it is managing. Then for the ESXi servers, important to note that these are hyperlinked too. So from this vCenter server, I could go to any of the ESXi servers that are on it, just to take a look at some more information. So we'll do that, head over to one of the ESXi servers. So here again, we have an overview page of the ESXi server. Basic information is shown at the top, some basic hardware information, as well as operating system information and BIOS, etc. One important thing here to note as well is that under the config, if you want even more information, specific details, they are available. You just have to go to the config tab and you'll have even more information. Going back to our summary tab here, below our summary, we have the network information again, and then below that we see our guest machines. Again, those are hyperlinked, so we could go over to any of these and take a look at that specific machine again with more detailed information. This is just a normal Windows asset, so there's really no difference here, except for that now with the vCenter scanning, we link it all together, which means that, as you can see here on the right-hand side, we have a link to our ESXi server. So we could head back to our ESXi server with that hyperlink as well. And we can easily see throughout all of our assets, which machine they're hosted on, or you know, which machines they are hosting. So going back to our dashboard, we'll close a few things here. We'll close these additional VMware servers that we have here. And as you can see here, once you close a few things that don't need your immediate attention, it becomes very easy to just have a useful overview of which machines are on which ESXi server and are managed by which vCenter server. So heading over to the right-hand side where Citrix pools are being displayed. So we have one Citrix pool, which has multiple Xen servers, which then again host multiple client machines, as they call them. So similar to vCenters, you can start simply by heading over to the dev pool. So here we get a lot of detailed information about our pool. Below the summary information, we get network information as well as our Xen server hosts, which again are hyperlinked. So we can simply click on one of them. So here again, we get basic operating system and hardware information at the top. Then below that, we have disk information as well as network information. And then below that, we have our guest machines. Again, our guest machines as well are all hyperlinked. In this case, they are Citrix guests and they are not directly scanned. So these machines have only been scanned via the Citrix scanning method, which means there's less information available. Obviously, when you do scan these machines directly as a normal Windows machine, then they'll be combined into one asset page, similar to any other Windows assets, as I showed before with the VMware guest. It'll just have an extra tab with the additional Citrix guest information. Obviously, seeing all this information and going from page to page is very useful to browse the information and take a look at specific details. But obviously, if we want a nice overview for a specific use case, This is where reports come in. So we'll take a look at some of the new reports for the virtual environment scanning. So we'll head over to our reports tab and do a search for vCenter. Here we have a list of all the new vCenter reports. So we have a list of all available networks, data store clusters, as well as data stores, Esxi servers, vCenter information. So that's an overview of all the vCenter servers and their information. We have an overview of the VMware guest configuration, as well as network and snapshots. To take a quick look at one, we'll take a look here at our Esxi server overview. So here we have a list of all the Esxi servers that have been scanned, with some information about them, specifically BIOS information, state, and then hardware information as well. So as you can see here, there's a lot of detailed information about our Esxi servers. This is just an overview, obviously. You can adjust these reports, create your own to adapt them for your specific use case or the information that you are specifically looking for. So a similar thing goes for Citrix. We'll do a search for Citrix and take a look at the Citrix reports. So just like vCenter, we have a list of reports here. We'll take a look at the host summary. So here we'll have both of our Xen servers with specific operating system and hardware information and a lot of additional details, as you can see. Thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about Lansweeper, head over to our website, start your free trial, or take a look at these videos.